Today we are going to discuss about the book value per share. This is one of the most important indicators to determine the value of the company based on the net asset value. Let us first see what is the book value. The book value represents the minimum value of a company's equity and it is calculated based upon its financial statements. The company's financial statements will reflect the value of its asset as well as its liabilities. When you subtract liabilities from asset, the value is the company's book value. For example, there is a XYZ company and its financial statements shows asset worth of 10 million and liabilities of 5 million and the book value is 5 million. If XYZ company liquidates and pays off all its debts, the shareholders would have 5 million in equity to divide among the shareholders. Now let us see how it is calculated for per share. The book value per share equals to total shareholders of equity divided by total number of common shares. Let's apply this to the XYZ company. The company's total current asset value, that is 5 million divided by the outstanding shares, that is 2 million, equals to $2.5, that is the book value. The book value per share will not be always equal to market value of the share. If the stock is traded for $8, then as per the book value, $2.5, the share price is overvalued. If stock value reduces for $2 per share, then it is undervalued. If a company's share price falls below its book value per share, then the company could make a risk-free profit by buying the company and liquidating it. If book value is negative, where a company's liability exceeds its asset. So, if the company's book value keep increasing year over year, which represents that the company's current asset is increasing and the company is progressing well. Thank you for watching.